I think the movie has been successful because it portrays a very specific reality that exists briefly in a time and a space that are no more. And it talks about things that are evanescent, that go away, both in terms of our culture and in our identity. It's a movie about exile. It's a movie that, by being particular, has become universal, and it can't connect with everyone, because I think the true artist has a specificity that comes from truth, and this movie is all truth. And it tells you a story about the essential disfranchisement of a young man in a society that changes right before his eyes. He leaves for a moment, he's in exile for a moment, and finds himself a stranger in a stranger land, and then comes back to his country to be an exile within that country because what it was has changed. I think that is rare, a movie that you find being done so early in the career of a young filmmaker that has the wisdom and the complete control of the medium, that is formally impeccable, but at the same time very, very free narratively. And I think those qualities, which are very unusual at any moment in a filmography, are there present this early in this film. And I think it's one of the most memorable debuts on film, in Mexican film, in the last couple of decades.
I fully agree. And also, because it's a film that doesn't really have a reference in Mexican cinema before. It's a film that challenges the ideas of formulas to create its own cinematic narrative, in which that are completely supported on time and space. And the thing is that time and space is not the element in which it flows, but is part of the point of the film, in which how the contrast between two spaces, when you are two spaces that are sharing the same time, the same dimension of time, and the contrast that occurs like such, and because of that, it's a film about identity. It's an identity and the certainty of our identities, the defense of our identities, the challenge of how supported our identities are, how much our identities are based upon an external facade. And that's the reason I think is truly universal. Because the film has, same as it played fantastically well in Mexico, it has played all around the world. In certain countries, it's been like embraced as if it was their own. And besides that, it's guiding us through a very ephemeral culture that we're all very unfamiliar with. Mm-hmm. It's as if you go to another planet and you are just in, but everything takes place here in planet Earth. Not only in planet Earth, but in our case, Guillermo, you and me, in our country.
Yeah.
And in one hand, it feels so alien, but the human experience is what is makes it so universal.
Yeah, because the reality is that this movie is portraying a movement that came and went, basically. And when people say, well, you're Mexican, well, there is so many Mexicos. Even within Monterrey itself, where it happens, there are many Mexicos in Monterrey. One is the Monterrey of the rich people, one is the Monterrey of the middle class, and one is the Monterrey of cultures that exist in the periphery. No, outside of the big urban areas, and that even that reality, when you see it, when he comes back, it has completely changed. And in Mexico, we say in Mexico that our country gets reinvented every 6 years because we get a new president. And this movie shows you that it's much faster than that. It is the beginning of a change in which he was not present, the protagonist, and therefore he doesn't belong to that, to what he thought was his home, is not home anymore. And the movie, I feel also from a visual point of view, is absolutely remarkable.
It's amazing.
The cinematography, the camera movement, all the beauty that it brings with the pain thematically.
Yes, and how understated it is in one hand, and how powerful it is. And what is really, really heartbreaking is our character, who's completely like protecting and defending his identity, and to go back and to see that that world is gone.
Yes.
And how is he going to fit? Who's he going to be now?
But I think the beauty of the movie, and it's a very painful and beautiful movie at the same time, is that, as you say, it presents you with the usual melodramatic choices and discards them.
Oh, yeah, yeah. All just challenge all your expectations. That is what it, you told me that when you called me and said, you have to watch this movie. You have to see it. And says, what is it about? Says, you have to see it. I said, and you told me, you're going to have some expectations of where it's going, and then he's not going to go there. It's actually going to challenge that expectation, and he's going to go into another place that is more truthful and powerful and also truthful.
Yeah, and the fact is, it ends, spoilers ahead, right? It ends telling you that we're all, at the end, dancing alone. Mm-hmm. You know, dancing alone in the middle of nowhere.
About loneliness in many ways.
Loneliness, yes. And even loneliness in collectivity.
In collectivity. You know? It's a loneliness in connectivity. Yeah. And then arriving to another place in which he's supposed to be the outsider. And to connect with other people that are maybe even lonelier than him. Yeah. Like when he meets this girl, you know, that is the daughter of immigrants, and immigrants that they are trying to, that is struggling herself because now she's trying to become fully American while she's still not fully. You know, while our character is just refuses anything that is not who he is. And the heartbreaking thing again is to go back and to realize that what he built everything upon has disappeared.
There is a very, very wise decision making in this movie from the team that created it, in which they don't succumb to things that would be emotionally uplifting or emotionally counterfeited, you know, to bring a reaction from the audience. I think it truly is a remarkable film that everybody has to see. Well, I think Mexican cinema requires of talents like Fernando to continue. You know, he inherits a mantle that you can trace back to the golden era of Mexican cinema with somebody like Tintan, who was a comedian that for the first time articulated the binational nature of Mexico flowing back and forth from the United States and still creating a personal culture from that transitory state. And each generation of filmmakers maintains Mexican cinema alive in the world, even now when the moment is very difficult because the government support for Mexican cinema is evanescent or vanishing. And his importance is also in fulfilling, I think, the essential thirst for truth that we have in cinema. We want people to show us the truth. We want people to show us realities that are not ours, even if we exist in the same country and we existed at the same time, to show us things that are evanescent and ephemeral, but precisely because of that, precious and as valuable, because their permanence is not permanence guaranteed by the system, but exist outside of it. The tercos, or stubborns, which is the nickname of the characters collectively in the film, represents that the acts of disobedience and stubbornness are essential in Mexico for us to survive in a country where every breath, every heartbeat is an act of will and vitalist and absolutely necessary to survive against all the things that oppress the characters in the periphery, the police, the drug dealers, the societal pressure. This is a movie that tells us that essentially we are all dancing alone in the end. And to do that, he needs to show us the isolation of every character and how they are divided by class, by money, by nationality, and yet they can group together.
Yeah, and I think also Fernando is, I think he has proven to be not only one of the most important directors in Mexico, but I think he's proven to be, shown to be one of the truly important directors that the world has. His, what he did with his film is, there's no reference for it. There's no reference for it in Mexican cinema, for instance. It's a truly original. And I think that that's part of the power of the film, is that you're invited to go into this very specific world, in this very specific vision of this filmmaker. Yeah, the and with that wisdom that he approached his locations to make them absolutely truthful and genuine, he also approached his casting with casting people that are absolutely truthful to each one of these parts, most of them non-actors, or maybe all of them, both in the U.S. and in Mexico, as you said. But also is creating this or recreating these jams that they have of dancing and being able to create the complicity among all of these, among all of these actors he's working with. So I think that these kind of films, they need to be made, and they need to be supported. But in Mexico, that now is going through challenging times in terms of production, but in the world, I think that filmmakers like Fernando represent the torch for what is to come. And Fernando, for me, is already an inspiration. And mm-hmm. I believe that he will be an inspiration as well for generations to come, and from people of his own generation, that they can see that what matters is really the honest vision, the original vision.
It's true also that for me, the most salient virtue of the film is that it was made, that it got made, because the tercos, or stubborns, that's a perfect way to define Mexican filmmakers. We have kept cinema alive generation by generation by doing impossible defiance and sustaining movies that each of their existence is a miracle. Just like these guys that are oppressed by so many things, but understand that for the moment, they're dancing. And for that moment, they're alive. That is the essence of making a film in Mexico. Things are against us, things are difficult, but for the moment, we dance.